So there's a lot of anti-aging supplements that are vying for your attention out there. One in particular that has been flying below the radar for some time is called GlyNAC. In a previous video, I reviewed the research on GlyNAC supplements, which are a combination of glycine and N-acetylcysteine. In this video, I present the results of another human clinical trial. Let's take a look at it. In this clinical trial of GlyNAC supplements, 24 older and 12 younger men and women were given GlyNAC supplements at a dosage of 100 milligrams per kilogram for each glycine and N-acetylcysteine. The amino acid alanine was used as a placebo and used at a dosage of 200 milligrams per kilogram. So what's going on here is that the amount of GlyNAC that they received each day was based on how much they weighed. The more they weighed, the more they got. So what might this look like for you? If it helps, here is a breakdown of glycine and N-acetylcysteine for different body weights that I put together. I will point out here that the dosages for N-acetylcysteine and glycine that were used in this investigation are higher than what you see in typical supplements such as these two popular brands here. So keep that in mind if you're going to be experimenting with glycine and N-acetylcysteine for yourself. Okay, so this investigation has several interesting results, so let's get to them. So at the beginning of this investigation, the older adults had 66% lower glutathione levels than the younger adults. However, GlyNAC supplements restored glutathione levels to that of the younger people after 16 weeks of use. Not only that, but the glutathione levels in the red blood cells also improved as well. Total red blood cell glutathione levels increased by 173% after just 2 weeks, and the reduced form of glutathione, better known as the active form, increased in the red blood cells also by almost 260% after 16 weeks. No surprise also that the older adults had higher levels of cellular inflammation compared to that of the younger people. However, GlyNAC supplements reduced inflammation and improved the anti-inflammatory compounds starting after just 2 weeks of use. Something else that was seen in this study was that GlyNAC supplements also appeared to improve insulin resistance and fasting insulin levels too in the older adults who took these supplements. In fact, after 16 weeks of daily use, GlyNAC actually restored insulin function to that of the younger people. This supplement combination also appeared to reduce systolic blood pressure, the top number of the blood pressure fraction, but interestingly not the diastolic blood pressure in these older folks. And one more thing, triglyceride levels also dropped in the older folks by about 16%. It's further interesting that the supplement combination also appeared to reduce waist circumference in the older folks taking part in this study, and maybe also body fat too. However, this part about body fat can't be entirely proven just yet, so more study is needed. Now, what I found to be one of the most interesting parts of this investigation was that GlyNAC supplements seem to help older adults walk faster. By the end of the investigation, the older folks were walking almost as fast as the younger people were. And it gets better still because muscle strength in both the upper and lower body improved in the older adults as well, indicating that GlyNAC supplements appear to boost muscle strength in older folks. So one of the things that I brought up in my original video on the GlyNAC formula was that I wanted to know if N-acetylcysteine by itself worked as well as GlyNAC supplements. The authors of this investigation tried to address that concern by highlighting a few studies that appear to show that N-acetylcysteine alone didn't seem to work as well as the GlyNAC formula. They also point to what they call the power of three as an explanation for this, stating that glycine, N-acetylcysteine, and glutathione have actions that are independent of each other. In other words, it may not just be about glutathione. So this was a pretty interesting investigation, and from what I could tell, there was no conflict of interest, which makes it even better in my book. But it's got a few shortcomings that I want to call your attention. So one of them is that it didn't have an awful lot of people in the study, so I would like to see it followed up with a larger investigation. Something else that jumped out at me, and this may be a minor thing, is the use of alanine as a placebo. Alanine is an amino acid, and I would have preferred it better if the researchers had used something more innocuous, like maybe a sugar pill as a placebo. So this investigation adds to the growing list of evidence that the combination of glycine and N-acetylcysteine appear to have a wide range of effects in the body, including anti-aging, anti-inflammatory, and obviously antioxidant capabilities due to its ability to raise glutathione levels. Although, as the research should point out here, maybe there's more going on here than just the increase in glutathione levels from this supplement combination. Something else this supplement combination has going for them is that they are relatively inexpensive compared to other anti-aging supplements. If you've tried GlyNAC supplementation for yourself, leave a comment below and let me know what happened. Until next time, take care out there.